Hello everyone, today I'll be sharing a video regarding divide and conquer technique of phaco fragmentation. I learned this technique of phaco fragmentation when I started my phaco training. However, I don't do it on a regular basis now. If you are new in phaco or if you are planning to start learning phaco, you have to learn about the nucleus geometry. You should have an idea about its size, thickness, and along with its texture and behavior. Divide and conquer technique offers to learn about the nucleus behavior and geometry. The first prerequisite of divide and conquer is to decent size intact capsular axis. Then start making a trench in the nucleus with moderate power and moderate vacuum. Your trench should be shallower at the periphery and deeper at the center. Practically, your trench depth should be almost equal to the thickness of your phaco tip. Rotate the nucleus to 90 degree and again start making trench and make a plus sign in the nucleus. Complete the plus sign and adjust the depth of at places with the lower power. If you are sure about the depth of crater, then place both instruments in the crater and try to split in two pieces. As the name indicates, divide and conquer. To conquer the nucleus, perfect division is the key of success. So again, rotate the nucleus, place both instruments in the crater and try to split the nucleus. And you can see easily you can split the quadrants. Again, rotate the nucleus and now place and split the nucleus in fragments. Now you have four equal fragments for the phaco fragmentation. Now grab the one piece, place it, bring it at the level of iris plane, and you can do safe fragmentation. Now rotate the nucleus, bring another fragment at the level of iris plane, and you can do fragmentation. So because your fragments are loose and they are free in the bag, and very easily you can bring it at the level of iris plane and you can do very safe fragmentation, saving the corneal tissue, endothelium, and the posterior capsule. Remaining epinuclear plate you can remove with the lower setting of the phaco tip. For the safe cortical cleanup, always go underneath the capsular axis under the visualization and grab the tip of the cortical matter, and you can pull it towards the center, and by circular manners you can clean the whole bag without creating any problem. Wash the posterior capsule with the hydrojet technique to polish the remaining cells and fibers, and now eye is ready for implantation. Here I did I implanted single piece hydrophobic implant in the bag, and you can do cortical cleanup. Go underneath the lens, remove the all viscoelastic, and then place the eye well in the bag, and then you can wash the viscoelastic or OVD thoroughly from the antechamber, from the all angles and over the lens. Then hydrate the wound and your surgery. If you want any further improvement from my side, please address me, and please leave comments. Thanks for watching.